Glory be to God. Hallelujah. This is a blessed day for you, a day that is full of grace and glory. It is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice and will be glad in it. Is your season for undeniable favor? Is your season for divine remembrance and restoration? For when the Lord restore again the captivity of Zion, we were like them that dream. Then was our mouth full of singing and our tongue full of joy. For God has done great things for us. Therefore, we rejoice. I know in this season, God will do something great, mighty, and marvelous in your life in the precious name of Jesus. This is Moment of Empowerment with Benjamin Beckley, and I remain your privileged host, Benjamin Beckley of the Empowerment Center in Arlington, Texas. You are welcome. I want to bless God for your life. I want to appreciate you for tuning into this broadcast today. And I know you shall surely be blessed of the Lord. You will encounter the situation transforming power of God's word in the precious name of Jesus. Thank you for all your calls. We appreciate you. And for everyone that has been calling in for prayers, I know you have a testimony. We value them and we do appreciate you. The Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. Now, by the grace of God, I'm still giving out an absolutely free prayer message, the prayer package that is entitled Prophetic Daily Prayer. I want you to call that number right now. Place a demand for your copy. We're still giving it out. Request a copy of the prayer message. It will bless your life. It's a prayer message that is designed to empower you towards taking and enjoying the blessedness of every day. You will understand in that prayer message how every day is loaded with benefits and how every day also attracts evil. The Bible says sufficient for each day is the evil therein. So I'd like you to place a request, order for a copy of that prophetic message. It will be a blessing. You can dial the number. You can place an order. Just a request for it. It's free of charge. It will be mailed down to you wherever you are in the world. Request for it. You can go on the website. You will find a request button there. You can click on it, or you dial the number on the screen. It will be mailed to you, and you shall surely be blessed as you listen to it anywhere in the world in the precious name of Jesus. Also, I look forward to having you come around to celebrate Jesus with us at the Empowerment Center in Arlington, Texas. I can guarantee you that every moment you spend with God is an investment that yields massive returns. Every time you spend in God's presence will always change things for you and release to you presents from heaven that will make your presence in life resultful. You are not here on earth by mistake. You are designed to make it and to rule your world. However, you need to be empowered. That's why I'm inviting you to join us at the Empowerment Center in any of our services. We meet on Sundays at 10 a.m. to 12 noon on Sundays. And on Thursdays, we meet 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. at the Empowerment Center. The address will be scrolling on the screen right now. The Empowerment Center is a place of empowerment for destiny fulfillment. And you don't want to miss that. Any day, anytime. I look forward to receiving you, and I can tell you, you shall be greatly blessed in the precious name of Jesus. It is well with you in Jesus' precious name. Now, I'd like you to call somebody right now, get someone seated with you, go on your Facebook page, go on the wall, go on Twitter, send a message out. That Moment of Empowerment is live right now, is on. Let somebody come and connect with power that will change our circumstances, the power of God that will put us in control over the situation of life. Moment of Empowerment is a prophetic and revelational broadcast that is designed for empowering you towards taking your rightful place in destiny. Listen to me. There is a place for you in life. You are not a creature of mistake. You are not a creature of accident. You are made by God. You are designed by God to have impact on the earth. You are a value adder. You are a product of intention. You have a place on earth. You are released onto earth to add value to it. You are on earth to advance it, to make good things happen on the earth, to occupy your space and your place on the earth. In Isaiah chapter 43 and verse 17, the Bible says, everyone that is called by my name, I have created him for my glory. I have formed him, I have made him. So you are God's creature, designed for glory. You are not designed for shame. Therefore, I curse the root of shame in your life. You will no longer know shame in Jesus' name. That circumstances that is bringing shame to you, I command them to be over. You are a product of glory. You are designed to live a glorious life. Anything that is tampering with the glory of God in your life, I subdue them today in the name of Jesus by the power of prayer. What shame is coming to you from your children? The shame coming to you because of your marriage? The shame coming to you because of your career? Anywhere in the world where you are listening to me and watching me and you are under the yoke of shame and reproach, today I declare the time to turn away your reproach in the name of Jesus. It is your time to step into your glorious destiny and manifest in it on time. So there is a place for you on the earth. You are not on the earth to while away time. You are on the earth to advance it, to make a thing happen, to cause a change, to influence the earth positively. Let there be a mark of your coming on the earth. And that is why there is a place for you on the earth. And I have good news for you that your place on the earth is not an ordinary place. Your place on the earth, according to scriptural revelation, is a high place, a high place. There is a high place for you so that you can live God's kind of life on the earth. Habakkuk chapter 3 and verse 19. The Bible says, the Lord God is my strength, and he will make my feet like eagle's feet, and it will make me to walk upon mine high places. Habakkuk chapter 3 and verse 19. It will make me to walk on my high places. So there is a place for you on earth called high places. You are supposed to be a high flyer. However, the prophet knew by revelation that I cannot get into my high place until I am empowered. That's why I said the Lord God is my strength. That means he's my strengthener, he's my enabler. He positions me. He said, he makes me to walk on my high places. The same God is still making his people to walk on their high places. You are going to get to your place in life. You are not going down in the name of Jesus. However, until you are empowered, you cannot take your rightful place in destiny, because the height of your attainment in life is a function of the depth of your empowerment. I'd like to say that again. The height of your attainment in life is a function of the depth of your empowerment. It is as you are empowered that you'll be able to take your place in destiny. And that is why the prophet said in Habakkuk 3:19, the Lord God is my strength. That is talking about empowerment. He's my enabler. He's the one that releases capacity into me to be able to step into my high place. There is a place for me. There is a high place for you. But you got to be empowered by God for you to be able to step into your high place. I pray over you today that as you listen to this broadcast and as you watch, the power that will skyrocket you to your high place in life will come your way directly in the precious name of Jesus. Glory, glory be to God. So know and understand that you have a place on the earth, but you must be empowered for you to take your place on the earth. Hallelujah. Now, in case you are just tuning in, this is Moment of Empowerment with Benjamin Beckley. And I am still your host, Benjamin Beckley of the Empowerment Center. Now, earlier I made an announcement that you can place a request for a free CD. Is an audio prayer message that is loaded to take over your day, to position you towards enjoying the blessedness of the day. So I want you to place a request for that. Request for that CD is a free prayer CD. It will be a blessing to you. It's absolutely free. We're going to send it to you. We're going to ship it to you wherever you are in the world. Dial the number right now. You can also go onto the website on the screen, to request for a copy of your CD. It will show you how to maximize the blessedness of the day and how to subdue the evil of the day. And you shall be greatly blessed as you place a request for that in the precious name of Jesus. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Now, today, by the grace of God, I shall be teaching and ministering on what I've entitled, You and Your Decisions. You and Your Decisions. And if you want to write that down, I encourage you to do so. You and Your Decisions. Listen to me. You are a product of decision. You are not just made. Your creation was based on a decision. Everyone created by God on the earth, we were all product of a decision that God made. In Genesis chapter 1, verse 26 to 27, the Bible says, And God said, Let us make man in our own image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the air, over the cattle, over the earth, and every creeping thing that creepeth on the earth. Now, verse 27, So God created man in his own image, and the image of God created him, male and female created he them. Now, from this scripture, insight reveals that everyone created by God was a product of decision. Let us make man. That was a decision. So God made a decision to make you. So from the beginning, your life is designed and ordained to be ruled by decision. Your life will also deliver via decision. You must understand that decisions are powerful. Decisions is what they determine the operations of your life. The way your life is being lived now, the way you live, the way you see things, the way you carry yourself is a function of the decisions you have made. You are where you are today because of the decision you have made yesterday. Now, you are watching me right now. You made a decision to watch me. And that is why I want you to understand that your decisions defines your destination. When you make a wrong decision, you get into the wrong destination. When you take the right decision, you experience the right result in life. And as you watch this today, I'd like you to know that you and your decision have a pivotal role to play in where you will end your life. Your destination is a function of you and your decision. Now, I'm going to share with you today three revelation insights about you and your decision. Now, if you have Bible wherever you are, please open your scripture with me to the book of Ruth chapter 1. Ruth chapter 1. And we look at scripture from verse 1 to verse 6. Then we consider certain revelational insights on you and your decision. Ruth chapter 1. We look at it from verse 1 to 6. And I'm going to read from here. The Bible says, Now it came to pass in the days when the judges ruled that there was a famine in the land, and a certain man of Bethlehem, Judea, went to sojourn in the country of Moab. And the name of the man was Elimelech, and the name of his wife Naomi, and the name of his two sons Mahlon and Chilion, Ephraimite of Benjamin, Judah. And they came into a country of Moab and continued there. They came into a country by decision, and they continued there. Now verse 3, And Elimelech, Naomi's husband, died, and she was left and her two sons. Verse 4, And they took them wives of the women of Moab. The name of one was Orpah, and the name of the other was Ruth. And they dwelt about 10 years. They were in the city for 10 years. Now look at what happened in verse 5. And Mahlon and Chilion died also. Come on now, you will not die suddenly. Both of them, they died also. And the woman was left of her two sons and her husband. Verse 6, Then she arose with her daughters-in-law, that she might return from the country of Moab, for she had heard in the country of Moab how the Lord had visited his people in giving them bread. God is going to visit you. He will visit your circumstances. He will visit your situation in the precious name of Jesus. Now, from this scripture, number one revelational insight I want to share with you about you and your decision is this. Number one, the decision you make outside of God because of situation will always attract destruction. Every decision you make outside of God because of situation will always attract destruction. Look at the scripture. The Bible says this man left Bethlehem of Judea because there was a famine. That was a situation. But he never made any right consultation with God or to consider what the city is all about before he moved. So therefore, he made a decision because of a tough situation without consultation, and it led to his destruction. The Bible says the man died when they got to the country of Moab. Their two sons also died. Four people left the country to go and find a greener pasture in another country, but lo and behold, the country consumed them. I need you to understand that many times it is not everything that glitters that is gold. Many are because they are looking for greener pasture have been bitten by the green snake. This man and his two sons were bitten by the green snake of the country of Moab because they were looking for greener pastures. Never allow tough situations to make you make decisions without consultation. This man left Moab, left Bethlehem of Judea, and they went to Moab. But you need to understand that there is something wrong with Moab. The word Moab, the country of Moab, was a cursed land. It was a land that had been cursed because it was a product of Lot's two sons sleeping with their father. And that was also a decision. The country was cursed because a decision was made by two daughters in Genesis chapter 19, verse 30 to 38, to sleep with their father. They said, we were going to cause our father to be drunk, then he will sleep with us. So the father slept with them, and because of the decision, the country was called Moab, and it was a cursed country. Now, Elimelech never consulted God, never consulted anyone before he moved to Moab. And because he got to a country that was cursed, how did I know it was cursed? The man died. How did I know it was cursed? The two sons died also. How did I know it was cursed? The two sons got married to people in the land, and for 10 years, they could not give back. Something is wrong with the land. Every decision you will make that will lead to your destruction, you will not take that decision. In the precious name of Jesus, every decision that will bring you down, God will give you grace not to make that decision in the precious name of Jesus. So understand that the decision you make outside of God because of situation always attract destruction. Therefore, be careful of making decisions under pressure without right consultation. Get your facts ready. Get your truth. Know something. Acquire relevant information and insight before you make a decision. Number two revelation I'm going to share with you from the scripture is this about you and your decision, is that the effect of your decision goes beyond you. The effect of your decision goes beyond you. It affects others. Every decision you make has a reproductive effect. It goes beyond you. The decision you make is beyond you as a person. It affects those that are connected with you. It affects those that are attached to your life. Look at what happened to the man. The Bible says, and a man, Elimelech, moved his family, his sojourn with his wife and his two sons. He made a decision to move because there was famine. But lo and behold, he was not the only one that died. Even the two sons died. He was not the only one affected. The wife became a widow. All because of a decision that was made without right consultation. So you must understand that your decision affects others. Your decision to live a right life affects generations yet unborn. Your decision to live a negative life affects generations yet unborn. When you are making a decision not to make the marriage work, it's not just going to affect you, it's going to affect your children. When you make a decision, consciously or unconsciously, to live a wrong life, it's not just going to affect you, you might affect other people that are innocent, unconsciously. So I want you to understand that the effect of your decision goes beyond you as a person. It affects others. The decision of Abraham to obey God when it was beyond him. It affected his generation, even up to this day, because we were part of the blessings of Abraham, because Abraham made the decision to follow God and to obey God. What decisions are you making? The quality of your life is a function of the quality of your decisions. So you got to be conscious of the decisions you make every day, every time, because it goes beyond you. You must understand with me, a man, a prophet, was called Jonah. He made a decision not to follow God's instruction. He made a decision to run away from God. And the Bible says because of the decision, he went into a ship on his way going to Tarshish. But suddenly there was a storm. There was a contrary wind. Now, Jonah was not the only one affected. His own decision to go and run away from God affected other people that did not even know him from generation unborn. I don't know who you are, but maybe because of somebody's decision in the past, you are paying a price for what you don't know. The Lord will redeem you. The Lord will rescue you. In the name of Jesus, many children are paying the price of the wrong decisions of their parents. Many also are paying the price for the wrong decisions of generations that they did not even know. Jonah made a decision to run away from God, and his decision not only costed him, it costed the people. Their properties, their goods, their resources were casted into the sea, all because they needed peace. Now look at what happened in verse 10, Jonah chapter 1, verse 10 to 12. The Bible says, "Then were the men exceedingly afraid and said unto him, Why hast thou done this? For the man knew that he fled from the presence of the Lord, because he had told them. Then said they unto him, What shall we do unto thee, that the sea may be calm unto us? For the sea wrath and was tempestuous. And he said unto them," look at what he said, "Take me up and cast me forth into the sea. So shall the sea be calm unto you, for I know that for my sake this great tempest is upon you. For my decision, this problem has come upon you." So when you make wrong decisions, it attracts wrong manifestations in life. So they took Jonah up and they casted him into the sea. The sea ceased from raging. There is someone listening to me. There had been a raging storm in your life because of a negative decision. I command today, whatever must leave for that situation to leave, I command them to leave. Everything that represents Jonah in your life that must be out of your life so that you can be out of the circumstances, I declare a divine separation. May the Lord push them out. May the Lord uproot them out of your way. In the name of Jesus, your decisions will not lead to your destruction in the precious name of Jesus. So be cautious, be careful of the decisions you make in life, because it affects not only you, it affects generations yet unborn. Jonah's singular decision to run away from God led him into destruction and also affected others. And finally, number three, you and your decision. I'd like you to understand that your distinction as well as your demotion in life is traceable to the quality of your decision. Your distinction as well as your demotion in life is traceable to the quality of your decision. So therefore, your life cannot rise beyond the quality of the decision that you are making on a daily basis. Your life cannot rise beyond the quality of your decision. Decisions can promote, it can also demote you. Decisions can put you ahead, it can also put you behind. Look at what Naomi said. Naomi made the decision after everyone has died to go back to Bethlehem of Judea because he had had a good news. In Ruth chapter 1, verse 6, look at what Naomi said. And she said that she might return, for she had heard that in the country of Moab, the Lord has visited his people by giving them bread. So when she heard that God has visited his people, she made a decision to go back. I know someone is listening to me that you know you have gone the wrong way. You have made the wrong decision. Now, that is not the end of your life. You can still make a U-turn. You can still turn. You can change your decision. She made a decision. Having seen that the decision has costed her, she made a decision to go back home. Somebody is watching me right now. You have left your wife. You have left your marriage. You have left your children. There is a need for you to make a decision to go back. Because until you go back, you can put things around. Everyone that they left together died in the country. But only she survived, all because God kept her. I know God is speaking to somebody right now that there is a need for you to make a decision that will change the course of your life. When she made a decision to go back, there was a reversal of the demotion that she has experienced before. How did I know she experienced a demotion? In verse 19 to 21, when she came back to the city, the people were asking, "Is this not Naomi?" They could not recognize her again because a decision has been made earlier that brought her demotion. So but now they say, "Is this not Naomi?" And she said, "No, don't call me Naomi. Call me Mara. Because I went out full, but now I've come back empty." You will not come back empty. Heaven will not allow you to be emptied in life. So your decision is important. Be cautious of decision that can lead to your demotion. Because what decision you make determines what happens and takes place in your life. So your distinction as well as your demotion in life is traceable to the quality of your decision. Ruth made a decision to follow God, a decision that led to her distinction. For 10 years, she was married, but there was no conception. But when she made a decision in verse 16, she said, no, don't tell me to go back away from you. Where you go, I will go. Your people will be my people. Your God will be my God. Where you die, I will die. That was a deep decision. That was a decision that transformed our situation. Decisions are destiny navigators. When you make a right decision, you step into the right dimension of life. I pray for somebody today that the decision that will lift you up, God will put it in your heart. You will connect with it. The decision that will elevate you will come to you. There will be an impression of it on your mind. In the name of Jesus, the decision you need to make to move forward, heaven is inspiring you right now. The decision that will move your business forward, settle your marital crisis, lift you up, expand you, is coming your way this season in the name of Jesus. So your decision is important. If there is any decision you need to make in life, it's a decision to serve God. It's a decision to follow God. Look at what Ruth said. Your God shall be my God. And that was what transformed our life. As you watch me right now, you need to make a decision to serve God. Serving God is never a loss. Serving God brings profit in. Serving God is an investment that yields great dividend. A decision to come to God, a decision to live for God, a decision to obey God, a decision to love God more than ever before. And I know God is speaking to you where you are right now. You need to make a decision to change, a decision to live right, a decision to stop smoking, a decision to stop doing what is affecting you. You need to make a decision to stop the addiction. You need to make a decision to do something that will change the course of your life. Now you are ready to pray with you. I want to pray with you. You are saying, Pastor, I want to make a decision to serve God, a decision to love God. Lift up your voice with me and pray this prayer. Say, Lord Jesus, I come to you today. Forgive me of my sins. I am sorry. Have mercy on me. I receive you as my Lord and my Savior in Jesus' name. If you have prayed that prayer, you are saved in Jesus' name. The grace that brought you will keep you. Now, I want you to continue to serve God, because as she was making God a God, everything changed for her. Your decision determines your destination in life. Now, if you just pray that prayer, I would love to hear from you. I would love you to call the number on the screen right now. And everyone listening to me, call in for prayers right now. If you are calling in, request for the free CD. It will be mailed down to you. Call in for prayers. Look at the numbers on the screen. Call that number right now. I'm going to be praying for you, and it is well with you. Now, as I round up, I'm praying for everyone. Get the sick on right now, because the power of God's healing is coming your way in the name of Jesus. Jesus made a decision to come and rescue the world. Therefore, I activate that decision in your life. It will work for you. You are rescued in Jesus' name. Every wrong decision you have made, may God show you mercy. Every decision that will lead to your promotion, may God give it to you to make. Aman made a decision to destroy the Jew, but it was revoked. Every decision to put you down, I reverse them. I revoke them. In the name of Jesus, it is well with you. The decision that will lead to your promotion, it shall be made in Jesus' name. The decision that will change your story will be made in Jesus' name. Wherever you are expecting an approval, receive the good news this week. Everyone sick, be healed in Jesus' name. God bless you. It is well with you. Now I'd love to see you at the Empowerment Center this Sunday or in any of our services. The information is scrolling on the screen right now. Come in. Let's celebrate Jesus together as we come fellowship at the Empowerment Center in Arlington, Texas. Till I come your way again next week, stay empowered and keep empowering others. God bless you.